Hello, welcome back to another episode of Minecraft Adventures with an interrupting Nick.
Should we start again? Oh!
I took the glory for that one this time.
Yeah, you saved me.
This episode, obviously. Oh.
This episode, we're in trouble.
Yeah, I don't know how that's doing that because there's lights on it. Well, it's not lights.
I don't think the silverfish spawners follow the same rules. They're mavericks.
Wow.
Which is very rude.
Yeah, that is just extremely rude.
Anyways, we've got a stronghold to explore this episode.
Yeah, and a mineshaft in one.
And a mineshaft, which we also... Go away, silly thing. Which we also found. So I think we should...
So hopefully we'll find some stuff.
Yeah.
We've explored this chest. It's all good. It's just full of junk.
Full of junk? All that junk.
Obviously, if you're... melon seeds and that, they're not that junk, but they are now because we don't need them.
Mm-hmm.
Get rid of that.
Oh, who did that?
That he just sunk into a block.
Oh, poor guy. Okay. I found a massive cave that leads off. I think this is it. There doesn't actually seem to be a stronghold here to speak of. This is looking like it's it.
As long as we've got the portal room, that's the good bit.
Yeah, we've got
that's what we
the
needed.
Portal. But, like, looking at this, really, there's, like, nothing here. Is there, really? It's kind of just the portal room and then that's it, just some corridors.
Tons of mineshaft.
And then, yeah, I think the mineshaft must have ruined it and kind of gotten in the way a bit. So, what do we want to do? Do we want to kind of explore each way together or should we split up? And maybe we should split up and people have a reason to watch both halves.
Yeah, that's true. But I don't know how much there is left. Oh, no, I thought that was a cave, but it's just a little tiny hole.
There should be quite a bit. I think, like, last time I found the spawn room and stuff, and there was quite a few branches that led off from there. So if I can find that again, then we should be okay. I'm going to grab some coal and some wood.
I'm actually running out of my pickaxe, which is not good.
Oh dear. Well, look, you're surrounded by wooden stuff, so make a crafting table and make yourself a new stone one for now.
Yeah.
That'll have to do, I guess. That's kind of like the advantage of going into a mineshaft, really. You can just stay down there and mine the whole thing without ever having to go back up to the surface.
You can stay down there forever. As long as you've got an ender chest.
Pretty much,
you'll be sorted.
Some food. If you've got a good supply of food in that, you...
Just put that there, why not?
You'd be made.
Oh, I've already got a crafting bench on me.
Oh, there you go, look at that, Mr. Prepared. Couldn't bring a silk touch pickaxe for the ender chest, though.
No, I didn't. Get some sticks, there we go. Got a couple more picks now, which is going to be good.
Yeah, that'll keep you going.
Run out.
I think that, I'm sure I've said this before on video and stuff, but I think that mineshafts should have, like, that some should spawn that are just dedicated to a certain type of resource.
Yeah.
So, you know, you'll still find all the other things in that, but it's kind of like you'll find a coal mine and there'll be much more coal than usual in it. Or an iron mine or something like that. And you just find a little bit more than the usual sort of stuff in there. And, you know, all the minecart chests will have more of that resource in them and stuff. I think that'd be a nice little feature if they could work out how to implement that.
I've left the mine shaft, and it's now led me into a massive cave that goes really deep underground.
Shall we go to that then? Where are you? Let me come and find you, and we'll go on that big old caving trip.
I've got a nice amount of gold there. Nice 8.
Oh, good.
Which is nice.
A nice 8 shot of gold. That's good.
I'm actually going to stop using my iron pick because just in case if I find anything valuable.
Let me find you. We'll work through this big old cave together.
Because there's no point getting like the coal because we've got tons of that back at home.
Yeah, but I'm getting a little bit anyway, good. So I can make
torches as well.
Yeah, so we can stay down here for longer. You're not that way. Let's grab some of this as well. Like a bit of iron. Especially where we haven't got a shaft.
Just still in the mineshaft. Could you get quite a lot? Oh, okay.
I'm out. What do you want?
I was going. I'll quickly go get some more of those planks, just in case.
Okay.
So we can get some more sticks.
I've got some, but yeah, maybe a few more. And I'll just carry on taking all this stuff out. Oh my god, this iron vein, you know, is pretty generous.
Oh god!
Whoa! Whoa!
Oh, you fell right on top of me.
I don't mean to laugh, but usually that happens to me. So it's nice to be on the other side for a change. Normally I'm the one doing the massive screams.
I lost 2 hearts, so that's not that bad.
Oh, look at that.
Even though he fell right in front of me.
That creeper knows nothing. Failed creeping school.
Yeah.
You want to be a creeper? No, sir. Oh, spiders. Okay, more mineshaft over here. And I'm guessing that that spider I heard probably wasn't one of the ones that becomes friendly.
No. Okay, this is weird. It pretty much looks like... Oh.
Floating rails!
Where? Oh, hang on.
Up here, and a ton of gold. I like floating rails. It reminds me that this game isn't perfect. One of many things to remind me that this game isn't perfect, to be fair.
But... It is still fun.
Oh,
even
yeah.
Though it's got its... drawbacks.
Oh yeah, its quirks is what makes it fun.
Oh, is this the one that we've already found, or is this another one?
Where
is the third spider spawner.
Oh, sweet. Cool.
We want it?
Yeah, why not? May as well keep them, I think. Yeah. I like keeping spawners. I try not to destroy them, even if I never go back to them again. It's nice to have them, just in case.
I'm, like, full of luck. I've been hit by spiders a couple of times now, and they haven't poisoned me.
Are they not? Well, I wonder, maybe I'm on easy difficulty here. I think we're on easy difficulty, that's why. What's that? I'm sure I set it to hard. Or at least medium. Oh dear. Well, that explains why this mineshaft has been so easy.
I'm going to have to grab some of this coal because I need more torches.
I'm going to have to do that between this episode and the next one. Remind me to do that. Can't be running around on easy anymore. No fun in easy.
No. Or peaceful at all.
Oopsie daisy.
Peaceful is just... didn't exist really. Not a game without more.
No. Although, well, I remember when I first started, I hated the mobs. I always used to turn them off when I went caving. I'd do my caving trips really tentatively. I'd start out like with them on, but then as I got deeper and deeper into the cave, I got more and more unnerved, so I turned them off. Because I'm a big old scaredy cat. Which is why, despite your request, I will not play Five Nights at Freddy's.
I think you just said it now. I think that's everyone's request. Now they've heard you say it, they're probably going to bombard you with comments. Oh, play it, play it, play it.
No, I will not play it.
There's a new one that's just come out as well.
Oh, I've been watching it. I've been watching Five Nights 4.
I watched Captain Sparkles just play the first night. And I didn't even watch the trailer or anything. And even that scared me just from someone playing it. I literally jumped out of my seat.
Oh yeah, I don't know. Five Nights is a really weird sort of game. I can see why.
It is a weird game, weird horror, but this new one is actually, I think, better than 2 and 3 because those were pretty bad.
Yeah.
Because it was impossible. You do night 1. Night 2, you just die instantly all the time. You just couldn't do it.
Number 2 looked really hard because of like the amount of animatronics you have after you. You've got like 10 in that game.
And now I think there's just 4 now in the 4th one.
A couple more. Ironically. Before, I think. But yeah, I think that I can see why.
Hello, diamonds.
Oh, nice find. I can see why. Just take them. Probably won't find them again. That's kind of the thing. If you haven't got Silk Touch, you've kind of got to just take them on the risk of not finding them again.
Oh, and tons of the red stuff.
Good. But yeah, like I can see why a lot of people hate it, because it's just sort of cheap scares, really, isn't it?
Yeah.
But...
It's like the film Insidious, really. Cheap knockoff.
Cheap
horror,
jumps, yeah.
Which is obviously just jumps. That's it, really. Nothing other.
But... The thing I like most about it is the story. I find the backstory really interesting. I think it's incredibly well written. Like me and Liam were talking about it, and we were kind
of
saying,
"Holy moly, that is tons of redstone."
Yeah, grab it.
You come here. You better come here and mine all this redstone. You'll be.
I will.
Your mouth will be jaw dropped.
I will if seriously. I can find you. But yeah, me and Liam were sort of talking about it and going, well, there didn't really need to be a fourth game. And I was like, well, no,
I don't think there even needed to be a second one, really.
I think, well...
Just the first, and that'll be it.
The first game was good because of the kind of game it was. The way it just kind of exploded in popularity is probably what every single game designer dreams of.
Yeah. So it gets to their head and they're like, let's do it.
Which I think is what happened for the second and the third, because they were just kind of squeezed out with almost
I think they were
no thought
both
and planning.
Released within like 3 months of each other.
Pretty much. And I think even though the fourth one was due for her like Halloween. And now it's come out
it's
just
now,
before August.
Even though the release date was August like something. And now he's decided now just released the demo now and then show everyone. So obviously it's only he's only put a couple nights in, but
yeah. Well, that's what he's always
good
done.
Demo.
Right? He's always kind of gone, well, it will come out this time, and then it just drops anyway.
Mm. He's like, actually, I can't wait, and neither can anyone else.
Yeah. But I think the fourth one's better because it went back to the first game's mechanics more.
Yeah.
I think
and
in
it's
the
got
second
new mechanics, obviously it's got like running and stuff, and you got to run to the thing and
yeah,
be careful and stuff. Whereas the other two and three were just like sort of, just look left, right, done. Yeah, we got that there, and then we got this here, and then we got that, and then we look at this.
Holy guacamole! Right, let's see how much we get. Right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 blocks. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27 blocks of redstone has given me just shy of 2 stacks of dust.
Wow.
Awesome.
I don't know if anything's down there. But I could water it up and we could mine down there.
Yeah, let's have a look. Who knows what treasures await us.
More redstone.
Cover that up. Nice. Some iron. Better get some blocks on the hotbar for this sort of adventure. Because, there's going to be lava above us. No more digging upwards just here. Never mind that. Okay, have we got any further we can go here? Maybe a little ways, but I think we're pretty much... Oh, hello. Eight. There's 7 bits out of that because I dropped one.
Oh, and
Butterfingers.
I think it's time to go.
Is it?
Yeah, run.
Why? Oh, what do you do that for? Oh.
It's a nice little...
Can't take you anywhere. Lovely. Should we try and make it back here? I don't know, is there much more exploring we can do up in there? I think we're kind of... I don't know. I've kind of lost the way. I don't know where we have been and where we haven't anymore. Oh, well, let's go up here. It looks like we haven't been up here.
Oh, well. That didn't go well.
Oh, dead end.
That's your fault now.
More resources, though. I do love the chimes that the XP orbs make.
I think someone's made a song of that, like a little parody song on YouTube with all the Minecraft sounds.
I wouldn't be surprised. I think it's quite easy to do. I think the sounds for the game are pretty well, if you'll pardon the pun, crafted to just go together quite well.
Oh, hello, Greenie. Go away.
Oh, that looks so epic. You know how like you draw the arrow back as you walk past? Right. I was kind of stood here walking up the corridor, right, and then you just kind of sidled backwards, drawing you like, come back here, like, I'll show you what it looked like. So, like, if you just sort of stand down this corridor here, down here, I kind of just saw you going, like, stumbling back, and then you went, like, looked amazing. Feels like you was running faster than I was, though. Can't work out how that happened, but must be something to do with your depth strider shoes.
Maybe. Oh, some iron.
I'm trying to look around.
Never have enough of the iron.
Never have enough iron.
Because for this world, we didn't have an iron farm.
We do not have an iron farm. What? You are humming at me? You could always look up how to build one yourself.
Terrible at building, really.
I ain't got a single clue how to go about building one.
The big house that obviously is on the world, obviously, that was just luck, really, that I just come across it. I was like, those ideas, because I got loads of ideas from previous builds, and I thought, you know what, bung them all together and see what comes out of it.
Yes, it was just luck that you happened to build that so nicely. Oh, dead end again.
Definitely a big project, though, that house.
It was.
Especially in survival. If anyone's watching and you want to build that, I'll probably do a tutorial one day on it. But in creative, of course, not in survival. you will know. Oh, hello, big room. You will know how hard it is. Because obviously, it took us a long time in this series to do it because it was in survival and it was a lot of resources. I think we had 100 plus blocks of dark oak to use that we needed.
And not much dark oak available.
No, we had to keep planting so many trees. more rail, more
here.
Torch. So we've been down there. There's another. There's the spawner.
This reminds me of many of the houses I've lived in.
they're all underground.
Because they're all underground. They're all more often than not built in some sort of structure. But I've lived in mine shafts, strongholds, all sorts. Just because it's nice and easy. Everything's built for you. My stronghold house I was really happy with. I loved my stronghold house. Which
that
was
good.
I don't think it was ever on a world I recorded on. I think I must have done a tour on it on a special video once.
Yeah.
Because I had I think I've still got the save for it, actually. But, it was a really nice house. I loved it. The mineshaft house that was... that became my jungle base on that world that we had the first, second, whichever one it was. I always get confused which season's which these days.
The one that just finished was 3 for me, so that I think that would have been 4 for you.
Yeah, the first one was the Twin Peaks, the mountains that I had.
Yeah, I think it was me, Sammy and Shelby came in on the second world.
That's right, yeah. The second one was the jungle base, then the third would have been...
the latest one was the...
The latest one was the Heinemann house.
Yeah.
In the Mega Tiger. So then I had the jungle base, and what else did I have? Because there's got to be another one, hasn't there? What else was there?
Oh no, it was the third one, which you had the Heinemann house. The fourth one was the one that we were all living in spawn, close-ish, weren't we?
Oh, yeah, that's right. Third one was the Heinemann, and then the fourth one was that the one with the
massive project you wanted to do.
Yeah, the mega storage room. Yeah. Oh, okay, that's
which it. Was never finished.
And it was never going to be finished. Even if we were still playing on that world, it would never have happened. Do you know how laborious it was to dig out that thing?
You should have just planted tons of TNT down and just blown it entirely.
We didn't have any sand or gunpowder though, you know.
And the desert was like 10,000 blocks away.
Yeah, and
we're never lucky with those certain rare biomes. Technically, a desert is rare now because
we're never lucky with it. We're never lucky with the biomes that we want. Yeah, is what it is.
It's like we could start off the series and we'll go, oh, hopefully we get, say, a forest biome for our spawn, but no, we get like a snowy tiger.
Yeah. I was sort of flying around the world the other day and came across a mushroom island biome that was completely landlocked, surrounded on all sides by other biomes. And it was like, well, this isn't a mushroom island. This is a mushroom place, really.
I would definitely love to live in a mushroom biome.
Oh, how easy would it be? No hostile mobs.
No, that'd be amazing. Just mushrooms, and they're friendly. Free food, tons of food. Mm-hmm. You can get steaks and mushrooms.
And milk them for their soup.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think the only way you can get mobs to spawn in mushroom ones is through the spawners, is it? I think I'm right in saying.
I think so. Yeah.
So.
And mycelium, that's good.
Yeah. If you find a dungeon, then in a mushroom biome, then that'd be nice, you know.
Instant farm.
Yeah, pretty much.
And then everyone's like, "Do you want to come down?" No, I'm happy on my island.
Yeah,
well, it's secure and away from everything.
Why would I voluntarily go to danger and death when I can live here in peace and solitude?
With a nice water temple, just a few hundred blocks from the distance, you're like, you keep hearing all the time is just the guardian noise. You're like,
oh. Yeah, I don't know if there's such a thing as a nice water temple though. Probably once it's been cleaned out, it's quite nice, but.
Mm.
I've had a look at some of those, like for sort of like layouts and stuff. I've never actually found one in game and been in one, but they look so confusing. I've only ever been able to make it to the room with all the gold in by like flying to it in spectator mode. I've never ever managed to sort of make my way there.
I have
legit.
Before, in my Let's Play series four.
Yeah, you managed it, but I could never find the way.
Took about 40 minutes.
Well, yeah, but
I defeated them all in the end.
Did you? How did you get them into there?
You have to get all of the puns. God, I'm so full of luck today. Correction, that's bad.
I would totally build a house in this place. Look at this, all my hollowing out's done for me as well. This is like the basement under the Heinemann house, this place.
What, with a nice skeleton dungeon underneath it?
Is there a skeleton dungeon here?
Yeah.
Where?
I have one, right in front of me.
Ow! Well, I've just been shot by one, I'm assuming that's nearby.
Got some iron, gold armor,
and a
name tag!
Yes!
I needed one of those.
I can see your name. Ooh! Ooh! Go away!
Tons of saddles, it's crazy. Iron, bread, redstone.
Yawn.
Redstone. Yawn.
What's
got
new?
Enough of that. Yeah, go on then, why not? Just craft all the bread. I don't need gunpowder, cobblestone, bones, flesh. Don't need diamonds. Of course I do. God, what am I? Keep the rails. String. Nah, get rid of that. Don't need it. Finally, I got a name tag. And I can name my cat. I have a cat.
Do you? His name is Gerald. Look at
now,
that. Pretty much the whole floor is made out of moss stone as well. That's not normally a thing. It's like.
And then we just got some more. That is boring. At least we've got some more horse armor we can bring back. Nay, might enjoy that.
Yeah.
There's no point making this a farm.
Not really. I'm going to pick up the moss stone though.
Yeah.
You're more than welcome to join me. Like, yeah, you wouldn't normally get this much moss stone out of a dungeon. Look at this. This is like almost a stack's worth already. And we only kind of cleaned out half of it.
Especially that we got like, I think, 10 from the jungle temple that we decided to raid.
Yeah.
But obviously, you know, I always find when I get mossy cobble, I'm like, yay, I don't have to craft it. But then, like, won't always use it a lot. So.
Yeah.
You might use it for like rustic themed buildings or like mossy cobble wall.
To be honest, I've only ever really used mossy cobblestone if I've built like a fountain out of cobblestone and I want to put some under the water so it looks like, well, moss.
Yeah.
But other than that, I don't think I've ever really used it in a build before.
Oh my god, there's a ribbon. I nearly fell down there. I had a mini heart attack. Thank you, Nick.
You are welcome. Well, we can't stop the dance show now, can we? Let's crack on. We just have to split this episode into two parts.
Yeah. Maybe.
How long are we at, Mr. Wolf?
We're about 25 minutes.
Oh, really? Feels like we've been caving for ages.
Mm. We can make this into one big special. Of like an entire exploring episode. Because now we've gone off the stronghold and then. Oh. We were idiots.
Were we?
Yeah, we didn't take down the coordinates.
For?
The stronghold.
Oh, I had like the F3 screen up while we was looking for it. I know there was like the rough area we'd need to head to.
Okay, that's good.
Like on the surface if we wanted to find it again. And then hopefully by that time we'd see like the hole in the floor anyway, especially given how big it is.
Yeah, put that there so we don't get stuff spawning down the water flume. Woo.
I mean, to be fair, we probably need to head sort of back towards the start soon anyway, because pockets are getting full and stuff.
Do you want to head this side?
Head what? I've run away a bit. A bat just flew in lava. You stupid thing.
Because I've just found a nice massive cave full of goodies.
Oh, really? Okay.
Lapis, redstone, lava, diamond.
That was dumb. What? Let me come. You've already got some.
I'm on it for the XP though, because I need the XP.
What? Okay.
Ow. No! Zombies. My diamonds, not yours. Well, not mine.
Did they pick them up?
Almost. How many have we got? I mined 4 for the first time. So you get... you get 5.
That's one way to skin a cat. Right, there we go. Oh, did you say you had 4?
I had 4. I mined 4 the first time, and then
I tell you what,
five are yours.
Put down your crafting table. Let's craft some of these stuff up. Some of this stuff up into blocks and that, so we kind of save a bit of room between us.
Get rid of that. Those.
You still got it?
Well, the crafting table. Yeah. First time ever I've crafted a block of diamond. Boom.
Perfect. And yeah, so just so we can save a bit of space, because I've got like loads of redstone dust and stuff that can be turned into a block.
I've got loads of rails and wood.
Okay, if you can make those...
use that for torches.
I was going to say, if you can make those into rail blocks, then that would be great and somewhat impressive.
I got saddles, which take up a lot of space.
Yeah. So, if you've got any more...
Here's a torch.
If you've got any more coal, or...
I've got 7.
Okay, I've got 4, so we can make at least one more block out of that. Have you picked up any redstone dust?
Nope.
No. Okay. Well, that's okay. That saves us a little bit of space.
All of the ore, and the apple, and the iron, the horse armour.
Don't need zombie meat.
Have you got any cobble on you?
Yes.
Could I have some, please?
Two and a bit steps.
Some more picks.
Well, there you go.
I'm actually going to make a furnace as well.
Okay.
So we can... Oh, no, I got some iron. I can make some pickaxes from the ingots already.
Well, I'll tell you what. No, we can still cook some up because I've got a load of ore here as well. So we can cook a load up.
Okay.
And,
well, I got another pickaxe anyway from 7 iron that I got from the dungeon.
Okay.
I'm going to make a couple stone ones as well, just for mining. And then furnaces. Have you got them?
There's two behind you.
Oh, okay.
So
there's all the ore in that chest.
Put a load in there. And that in there. Okay. And I'll tell you what, I'll just make another one so we can speed this along a bit. Whoa! Don't scare me like that! There we go. So those will start cooking up nice. Oh, wait, don't... Oh. Had some junk that I wanted to throw out.
Hang on. No, there's no more lava there.
Oh, boo.
There must be some here somewhere.
We'll find some.
No, that's it. It's all gone.
We'll find some. We're down on diamond level. There's going to be some somewhere.
Ah, lapis. Hello.
Hello, lapis, my old friend. Ha ha.
And, oh, hang on. There's the lonely one piece.
Ah!
I thought that was behind me then. You scared the hell out of me. There's an extra piece there. Look. Boop.
Ta-da. I like it when caving trips go like this, when you start having to like crunch things down because you got so much resources and stuff. So many resources.
If only, you know, somebody, me, had a silk touch pick so we can have an ender chest.
Mm-hmm.
But no, he totally doesn't think.
God, dear. There's some light down here. Ah, I spy lava. That's good. I mean, like, I've been carrying this iron door with me for ages. Like, what am I, why have I got an iron door?
I want to brock out the haters.
Freaking, like, I mined it when we was in the stronghold so that we didn't have to keep pressing the button to get through.
Yeah.
And now I've been carrying it all this time for like, why would I need an iron door?
You never know.
What on earth? Like, I've never had an iron door in my life.
Okay, so I found more gold. Yes, this is going to be good because we need lots of gold.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah,
and then
gold,
we've
got tons of the stuff.
And
now.
We've also got to still get the 9 blocks from the water temple. Yippee, it's going to be fun.
78,
it's going to be
isn't
like,
it?
It's going to be like an hour for us.
Oh, it's going to take
boss
so
fight.
Yeah, and then we'll find...
I kind of class that as a boss fight. I don't know if anyone else does.
I would, yeah.
It's kind of, obviously, yeah, it's
more challenging
really,
than a normal monster.
Yeah. And you still got the annoying guardians there anyway.
And this is the thing, like, it will take us an hour to do, and that will, that hour will be getting us all online in the same place.
Mm.
You know, it's like when we try and do something all together.
It
takes an ice age to even get going, let alone actually do the thing.
Well, I'm back at the furnaces, so pretty much hitting the half an hour mark. Do we want to call this episode here and then carry on?
We may as well carry on to 40 and then split into two,
okay.
I reckon. May as well. We've come this far.
Yeah, true.
So we may as well. We'll just agree a point to cut in half. Oh
yeah.
No, I've lost the furnaces. Where are you? I got greedy.
Follow this flaming arrow. If you can see it.
Oh, not yet. Oh, don't want to do that. This is what I find a bit disorientating when you've got like unbreaking on a pickaxe when it kind of when it breaks. I think it happens more on multiplayer than it does in survival, and then it kind of reappears in your hotbar.
Yeah.
And stuff when it as it's calculating the unbreaking bit.
Oh, God.
Oh, dearie, dearie me.
Dropping everything, look. Make some blocks. Just to, you know, get up all the space.
There we go. go out and get some more.
7 and 8 and 9. There we go. We've got another block.
It's a good. We'll be so
I'll
ready.
Just stay
for some,
here for a minute.
We'll be so ready for some fights.
Oh yeah.
With all this,
we've got loads of
all
iron.
This we're bringing
so we've
in.
Got all of this. We've got loads of the gold.
Mm-hmm.
Gold coming out of our ears. I've got 26 ore. So.
I got 39. So we'll be well and
I'm
truly
good.
I'm gonna
set up another furnace so we can put the gold in that one.
Okay.
You have any extra coal?
Yeah, I've got loads on me. I'm getting some more at the moment. You take those. Oh, do you want to take the gold as well?
Yes, please.
And there's some iron there you can have.
Wow, we have a stack of gold. Oh.
Perfect. That's exactly what we need. And now my enchanted pickaxe has gone, everything feels so slow. It's always the way.
Here you go, have some butter.
Butter! It's a nice quote for the Anchorman 2 fans. Do you ever see Anchorman?
Yes. I haven't actually watched the second one recently, though. I know it's out, but I haven't watched it yet.
I never watched the first one. I generally have a problem with Will Ferrell. I don't really like Will Ferrell.
Will Ferrell fans, do not hate.
So I kind of steered clear of, well, pretty much his entire film career. But
I watched Elf, because that was funny.
I didn't like Elf, because I didn't like Will Ferrell. I just didn't particularly like Elf either. But Anchorman, I didn't watch the first Anchorman for that reason. And then I was just away with friends and they put Anchorman 2 on and it was hilarious. I loved it.
Now it's just going to make you watch the first one.
Well, possibly. I loved, what's his name? Like Steve Carell's character. Is that?
Yeah. Brick.
Brick Tamland. Just hilarious. I think you couldn't get anyone else other than Steve Carell to play that character. I thought.
Do you have that single gold ingot?
Yeah.
Thank you. I was just going to make the blocks. This is pretty much the end of this episode, almost. Just making blocks.
just making blocks, watching things burn and cook up and stuff. But
we've got a nice
it's
array of colours now, look, Nick.
The amount of, like,
there we go. now we just need redstone and coal.
And lapis, of course, don't forget. But I can help you out with all those.
Coal.
There you go. All done. We want emerald now, but ain't none of that down here.
No.
Some of that back at home.
If only we had the emerald block and then the hay block, and the hay bale, and then that'd be like nice ore.
The wall
block,
of ores.
Sort of wall, yeah.
Do-do-do. Do-do. Bling. Be-do. Just crunching all these down. This is what it's all about.
I think probably as soon as the episode's done, we'll just do all this before we get the next episode ready to go, or record it, at least, because I don't think people want to see this for like 20 minutes, just me going in furnaces every now and then. Getting the ore. Getting the XP though, not bad. 32 levels.
Yeah. Oh, you're gonna overtake me. I'm 35.
Well, I'm not halfway yet on the 32 bar.
Oh, I'm approaching half on 35. We're halfway 35. There.
Jesus.
Yes, 35.
Someone doesn't rush.
I mean, to be fair, I'm wasting loads of levels here, you know, because. What more can you do once you reach 30? You need to start spending them. Because they don't add as much to your
I
bar,
normally
really.
I normally get to about 39 and then I get 4 chances at least with level 30.
Yeah, I mean that's true. The more you have saved up then you can just kind of do a mass enchant all in one go. But I don't know which way is probably more efficient.
Because I do like the new enchanting system instead. It's more expensive, but it's much more efficient, because now you know what you might get, or someone else, And you only take up 3 levels instead of 30 each time.
Yeah.
But anyway, I think that is it for this episode.
Thank
you so much for watching, and we will see you next time, probably just about to leave this place and on the journey home.
I reckon
we will see you next time. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye everyone.